Everyone, welcome to Femacy Lighthouse. I want to thank you so much for being here with me once more on my channel. Of course, to book a private session with me, all of that info can be found in the description box below of this video. Today, I will be uploading Taurus versus Capricorn, and I'm doing a love reading for Cancer. So if you are not yet a member of the Femacy Lighthouse VIP, I will put the link for you to join in the comment section. Before we begin your reading, the moon is in Taurus today, and there are a lot of sextiles going on around your sign. What do I mean by sextiles? A lot of mental stimulation, all right? So a lot of good energy, a lot of green energy, good energy for work, good energy for money, good energy for popularity, mental stimulation, all right? So you're lit right now, basically, and you got other people lit. Let's take a look. Spirit, please speak to me in reference to the recent past. Talk to me about the recent past when it comes to energies that surround Taurus. You have the Lovers coming out here first. Gemini energy for some of you. Tell me more about this contract, these two people around each other, coming together. You and this person are very much alike. They want what you want. Okay, let's put it like that. All right. Tell me more about the Lovers. Page of Wands coming out here, Sagittarius, Gemini. Tell me more about this Page of Wands. What is this message all about? All right. So we have the Lovers and then the Page of Wands. Someone needs to discuss something with you. They want to talk. All right. They do. That's the energy that's presenting itself. So I don't know if you're not talking to this person or if you haven't spoke to them lately. Maybe you did speak to them, but this is an energy that speaks to messages coming in, messages going out. And it also speaks to collaboration. Tell me more. Spirit, talk to me about this Page of Wands. Oh, Capricorn coming out here in reverse though. All right. So it's like this person telepathically, they're trying to communicate with you at this very moment. They are trying to get you to understand something through your dreams as well. I feel like they could be asking their higher power to communicate with you through your dreams so that you can understand something, all right? They're trying to get you to understand something, but in the 5D realm. This is someone that you're not really talking to, all right? But they are speaking with their God, and they are telling their God to connect with you through your dreams so that they can get a point across. And to tell you the truth, that's the best way to do it. Especially if you're dealing with a spiritual woman or a man, right? I just feel that you gotta speak to your God. That's what you have to do. Telepathically approaching me is the best way. With me, there's no other way. With you, I don't feel there would be any other way either. You are a spiritual person. Like, that's what activates you. It's like somebody does not want a problem here, is what this telepathic energy is trying to say. Like, that's what I feel they're trying to say. Tell me more. Tell me more about Six of Pentacles, balance. You see the scales? Tell me more about this. Scorpio energy pulling up here. Why? Talk to me about the Scorpio. What's going on here with that? Eight of Swords. Who is this? Who is this? Please. Eight of Swords energy. I don't feel like that's you. That's not you. Like, do you feel like you're like this right now, Taurus? I don't feel like you are, but some of you may be in this position. I don't feel like this is you. I feel like this is someone around you. Tied up, overthinking. Too many swords are piling up there, which means too many thoughts are piling up and someone's not doing anything about it. If you don't do anything about all of the thoughts that are piling up, you will end up feeling like you're tied up in rope. Talk to me about the present. That was the recent past. Talk to me about the present, please. The Hierophant is in the present. This is you with all of the sextiles going on around you, like I stated at the beginning of the reading. A lot of mental stimulation. Tell me more about that. Talk to me about the Hierophant. You see how there's two men that are looking up at the Hierophant? You could have two men that are heavily watching you at this time. Clarify the Hierophant. Taurus coming out there. The Star. Aquarius. Beautiful energy. The Hierophant with the Star right next to it, Taurus. Really? Absolutely. I'm gonna take it. We're gonna take it. Tell me more about the Knight of Cups. You got somebody approaching you. Did you meet somebody new? All right. Either that or dreams are coming true. Knight of Cups to the Star. Hierophant, Knight of Cups, Star. It's like you're traveling in the right direction, Taurus. So keep up the great work. For some of y'all, there's a Capricorn that's pissed off, or there will be a Capricorn that is pissed off. All right? With the Devil coming out here in reverse. Tell me more. The Nine of Wands. Okay, here goes the jealousy. Here goes the jealousy from this person. All right, take a good look at this person. Fire energy coming out here. Could be an Aries, could be a Leo, a Sagittarius. I feel here, Nine of Wands, Nine of Cups. Someone sees you basking in your glory and they're tight about it. Who cares? Keep going. You know what I'm saying? I'm just here to let you know that this is in your environment for today's reading. But this person, you know, they don't have significance. Who cares if a hater is around? You know what I mean? Who's a fuck? But I'm just letting you know. Now, tell me more about the Nine of Wands. Scorpio, tell me more. King of Swords. Somebody really fell off here. This feels like somebody who fell from grace. This feels like somebody lost their touch, that they're not who they used to be anymore. Like, that's what this feels like. And they're watching you keep up with, your mission. Like, you always had a mission, or you were really good at something. You were meant to be in the public eye. You stayed on course, and there you are. Someone fell off. Someone around you fell off course. I think now they're identifying that. They're like, shit, I mean, what the fuck happened to me? Yeah, what happened? Uh-huh. Sometimes we have to ask ourselves that. Hold up. Did I change the trajectory for myself by making the poorest choices I could ever make? That's what someone is saying to themselves. This looks like a fall from grace. Somebody is not on the right path. And I don't know, this looks like a flop. Somebody is flopping. This is somebody that fell on the charts. I don't know what happened here. It didn't work out, or they're not on the path that they wanted to be on. It's just not going in that direction. Like, this person, it seems to me like somebody got dropped from the label because they weren't making enough sales. They got demoted. You know what I'm saying? Not promoted, they got demoted. They're losing credibility. They are ruining their reputation. They are, I don't know, somebody just dropped. That's what it looks like. It's a whole drop. Tell me more. Somebody downgraded. That's what it looks like, a downgrade. It's like they're going in reverse. They're going in the wrong, I don't know what they're doing. This person, it just looks like they fell off. That's what it looks like. If you're not true to yourself, you will fall off. You will. If you're not honest, if you're not authentic to what you really want, and you're doing things to please other people, even if you know you shouldn't be in that position, you're going to fall off the charts. You're going to downgrade. You are going to get demoted. Somebody got demoted, not promoted, demoted. Talk to me about the future when it comes to this energy. Someone is losing themselves. I don't know who this is. They're not true to who they are or what they really want. Like, they're not following through here. I don't know why that is. It has to be the people that are in their environment. Because if I'm not being true to my career path or where I want to go, then it's the people around me that are fucking it up. And I have to figure that out. But some people, they don't fucking listen. Some people, it'll be right in their face and they're walking around acting like a dar-dar. You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, wake the fuck up. And then it'll take a Taurus to get you to see some shit. Talk to me about the future. We have the Two of Swords. Tell me more about the future. Two of Swords. Three of Wands. Yo, somebody is like, they're looking at you, do this. Take a look. This person right here, Taurus, for each of you, this is somebody different, right? Because it's not always about love. We could be talking about your family member, your coworker, your best friend, whomever it is. It's up to you to understand the metaphor. Intuitively, you'll know who I'm talking about. Look at this person watching you with the Two of Swords. They know that, or they feel that you don't want nothing to do with them, or that you're tight about something. You see that? You see how they're looking at you? You're the Two of Swords right now. Right? Because in the last reading, you told somebody to go and fuck themselves. So they're watching that. Tell me more about this Three of Wands. What do they want? What? Talk to me about the Three of Wands. Three of Wands energy. Yeah, this is what they want. They want the magician. The magician is you, honey. You are the magician. You're the spiritual one. You're the manifester. You make it happen. You're the professor, as a matter of fact. That's who you are. You're the teacher, like the magician. We have Aries, Virgo pulling up there. Shout out to Aries. Give me more on that magician, please. That's what they want. They want the magic. You got the magic, Taurus. You got the magic. See, I told you they want the magic. Right as I'm saying that, here comes the ace, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Anything else for Taurus? Tell me more. I told you. Listen, how many different ways? Look at this. Somebody wants to be nice to you. All right? You're over here. There's a choice that you need to make. It's coming in. Be very careful. Don't let anybody just say that they can meet up with you anywhere. Nah. If anybody wants to meet up with you, make sure you come with your security. All six of them. Okay? Yeah. Everything on. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So don't just meet up with anybody randomly. No, no. I'm just saying, just think it through. Think it through. You do have an option. So you have to figure out which way you want to go. I know that you're going to make the right choice. All right, you're the professor, remember that. Like, you highly, highly educated, okay? So there's somebody here that's coming in to say something, all right, as you can see, and then you have the choice to make. You're going back and forth about what you're going to do, right? But let's see what happens. All right, so that's what I have for you, Taurus. To book a private session, all of that info is below. Take care.